A lot of you have been curious about some patent from Microsoft that on the internet people are referring to as the 666 patent, the patent of the beast, that people on the internet are saying this patent is about implanting microchips into people. So I thought I'd actually look into it because, I love patents and then anything related to, the devil is fun. Just, gird your loins. I hope that wasn't dirty. I don't actually know what loins are. You don't either, do you? Okay. Okay. So, first off, here's actually the patent publication that everybody is talking about. It's a publication, it's not actually a patent yet. So, this is just a patent application being published by WIPO. But this is what everybody's talking about when they talk about this 666 patent of the beast. And what is this patent about? Well, it's about a cryptocurrency system that uses body activity data from a person as part of crypto mining or data mining. Now, I'm not an expert on cryptocurrency, so I'm not going to teach you a little class on cryptocurrency systems. That's beyond the scope of this course. Actually, the title of the patent application is Cryptocurrency System Using Body Activity Data. So, I'll give you kind of a higher level view of what's going on first off. Before we get started, I did want to note that this patent actually, there's a US patent application that was filed first for this. And you can see here that it was published in March of 2020. And it was actually filed. Here's the filing date because I can't remember what the filing date was, but I circled it at some point. So here's actually the filing date. So it was filed in the US first. Then it was published by WIPO as this International Patent Application publication. All right. So first off, does it have the number of the beast in it? 666. Well, you can see the number. There are three sixes. Where do these three sixes come from? Well, I'm assuming, 666 is like the area code of the devil, I'm guessing. Like the 212, the 815, I don't know, the 666. I'm not. There are three sixes in it, separated by zeros. Some people are saying that this WO stands for World Order, and it does not. It actually comes from WIPO. So WIPO stands for World Intellectual Property Organization. So the WO, I guess, stands for World Organization, which is very different than World Order. So I did search through this and I didn't see the word vaccine used or vaccination used in this patent publication. So let's look at the big picture here. If you look at this figure one, this is kind of showing you the big picture of what's going on in their patent application. And what they're trying to do is use people as part of cryptocurrency systems to do crypto mining, I believe. They say, for example, a brainwave or body heat emitted from the user when the user performs a task provided by an information or service provider, such as viewing advertisements or using certain internet services, can be used in the mining process. Instead of massive computational work required by some conventional cryptocurrency systems, data generated based on the body activity of the user can be proof of work, and therefore, a user can solve the computationally difficult problem unconsciously. Okay, so if you're looking here at figure one, like the thing that most people are really talking about is what's going on with the user and this sensor and the user device. Okay, so that seems to be because people are saying there's a chip that's implanted and then they can monitor you a lot. I mean, it's the internet. They're saying all sorts of things. But let's actually dig in. First off, let's talk about the user device. So what could the user device be? This is at 130. Well, the patent application says that the user device may include personal computers, servers, cell phones, tablets, laptops, smart devices, e.g. smartwatches or smart televisions. Okay? So that's what this patent application says the user device can be. Now this sensor, which is element number 140, I think that's what people have people really excited, is this sensor, okay? So the sensor can be configured to sense the body activity of a user. Alternatively, sensor 140 may be included and integrated in user device 130. For example, user device 130 may be a wearable device having sensor therein. The sensor may transmit information data to user device. All right. So it did not say that the sensor was implanted. Okay, so this task server, they're going to send tasks from this task server to users, to people. What kinds of things might they send them? Okay, task server provides one or more tasks to device of user over communication network. The tasks include, for example, but not limited to watching or listening information, like an advertisement for a certain time, using services like search engine, chat bot, email, social media, networking service, and any other internet or web service, uploading or sending information or data to a website, server, or network, or any other information or service which may produce effects on a user. Okay? So they could send a lot of those different kinds of things to you, to your device, and then just see how it affects you so that they can get this body activity data, it sounds like. Well, the body activity may include, for example, but not limited to radiation emitted from the human body, brain activities, body fluid flow, blood flow, organ activity or movement, body movement, and any other activities that can be sensed and represented. Did you guys catch that? Just a minute. Blood flow and organ movement. That could mean, I don't know. I don't want to be dirty, but it sounds like, you know, I don't know. It just sounds like something. Examples of body radiation emitted from the human body may include radiant heat of the body, pulse rate, or brain wave. And when they talk about brain waves, they talk about beta waves that are in logical thinking and conscious thought, alpha waves, which related to subconscious thoughts, theta waves, it's involved in deep and raw emotions, and delta waves, which is involved in sleep or deep relaxation. So if you're having a scary dream, I would think that, like, holy crap, he's scared. Or if you're having a dirty dream, they might know. Well, so that's my quick look at this Microsoft patent that people are talking about. All right, I hope you've enjoyed the review of that patent application. Again, I didn't see anything about the sensor device being implanted. I think it would be pretty comfortable, you know, wouldn't be a big deal. Sure, you might have a hard time getting a table at a restaurant. And, I do have a hard time sometimes getting dressed in the morning. But other than that, but it looks good, doesn't it? Okay. All right, you guys, if you've enjoyed this, subscribe to my channel, watch my other videos, tell your friends, spread the word. See ya.